Now I'll tell you, Tableau is business intelligence tool. Tableau is a business intelligence tools which helps you to take quick decisions. How? Visualization, you have understood from morning, we are doing the same thing. Business intelligence tool. You remember, Ayushi used to prepare 12 months, 12 reports every month. Now, if you can prepare it only one time in a year, that is obviously making your business more smarter here. Second is how it can help you to take quick decisions. How it can help you to take quick decisions. I have a demo over here. Everyone, demo. Please see the demo here. I'm dragging here subcategory into rows, and I'll drag profit into text. Profit into text. This has created a simple table here. Let me increase the size. I know it is difficult for you to read. Please tell me what are the non-profitable subcategories. This question is for everyone. Can you please tell me how many subcategories are having profit below zero?
Tables.
Three.
Right? Correct. I understand it. It is, the answer is three: bookcases, and then supplies and tables. So correct. Now, can you tell me? Now, can you tell me how many are there below zero? Yeah. Now. Sorry, I'll not move the screen. Now, is it? How many are below zero?
Five are there.
One, two, three, four, five. Correct. It has taken some time, but the answer was correct. Now, how to take quick decisions? Just have a look on my screen. So I'll do it twice. See, for the first time, when I drag subcategory into rows, and I have dragged the sales into, sorry, profit into text. That was a method. So instead of doing that, what I can do is I can convert this automatic to a shape. I can convert this automatic to a shape. So this will give me one single shape here, one single shape, which is a circle shape. I can change the shape by selecting the options. I will do it twice. See, for the first time, I can change the shape from here. But the question here is, I want this shapes to change depending upon the profit. If profit is above zero, then some other shape. Profit below zero, some other shape. So I'll go to some menu bar, and I'm going to create one simple calculation. Okay. Simple calculation as a create calculated field. Just observe. Do not do it. The calculation I'll write as very simple calculation, and tell me if it is difficult for you. Sum of profit greater than zero. Simple calculation, sum of profit greater than zero. So the output of this value will be either true or false. Correct. The output of this value will be either true or false. When I click on apply button, when I click on apply, carefully observe, the profit status is created here equal to TF. Equal to stands for calculated. TF stands for true and false, which is a Boolean data type. So let me mute someone. Mute. Correct. So what I can do is I can drag this and put into shape. I'll be getting two shapes. One is false will get a circle, true will get what you call square. I don't like the square and circle. I can click on shape, and I can click on shape, and I can pick up some good interesting shapes which might be available there at the back end. For false, I'll pick up down arrow. For true, I'll pick up up arrow. And I'll increase the size here. So see, forget the steps. I'm telling you the steps very soon now. When I drag the profit into label, and now you can tell me how many are not profitable. Three. Okay, which you give me the same answer, but this time the pain would be less. This time the pain would be less. And now if I drag segment into columns. Now, if I drag segment into columns, can you observe here? It is a bit easier than what you have done earlier. Now you can quickly tell me, like, how many are the subcategories in those segments which are below zero profit? So Tableau is not only a visualization, but it is helping you to take quick decisions by creating this kind of KPIs, key performance indicators. Was it difficult? If you observe nothing, it was just a simple calculation and drag and drop, very simple options. Let us prepare everyone, then you can ask me the questions. First, prepare. Drag subcategory and profit. Drag subcategory into rows and drag profit into text. Next one. So this table was there, which was helping us to give the answers, but today it is a very small table. Tomorrow it will become very big. Click on this button and select shape. Click on automatic and you can select shape option. When you select the shape option, you get some not so good looking report here. Press Control right arrow key, everyone. Press Control right arrow key and Control up arrow key. Keep on pressing Control right, Control right, Control right, and see what happens. Control right will try to increase the width of your screen. Control right arrow key and Control up arrow key. Right. See, Control right will move on the right hand side. Control left will move on the left hand side. Control up will increase the size, the height. Control down will decrease the height. Right. Next one. Click on the shape and pick up any one shape, you see. Click on shape and choose some different shapes.
Pavan,
Yeah.
how are you getting the numbers against the subcategories, the profit?
I drag the profit into label.
Okay, thank you.
Profit into label. Okay. Now, if you see, I'm getting only one shape. You also might be getting one shape. I don't want one shape. I want two shapes, one for profit, one for loss. One for profit and one for loss. So we have to write one calculation. Everyone, please go to analysis menu bar and click on create calculated field. Analysis menu bar, create calculated field. And here you can write simple calculation. Analysis menu bar, create calculated field. And it's very, very simple calculation. Let me zoom the screen for you. Some people will get error. Please ask me if you're not able to get the answers.
Pavan, did you write that manually or did you select it from the table?
No, you have to write it manually.
Hey, Pavan, one question is that so
Yes.
once you create this, So once it creates a calculated field, this is available only to this particular
all the sheets will be getting all the sheets.
And Pavan, that profit status, whatever there in that column, so that also you manually entered, is it?
Profit status, yes. The name can be anything, profit status or ABC, anything you name profit, that I've entered manually. Right. Now, if it is done, now you can click on apply and OK. Now you have to drag that profit status into shape. Drag that profit status into shape. Then click on shape, drag profit status into shape, and then click on shape. And for false, you can select down arrow. For true, you can select up arrow. And then click on apply.
Pavan, can you show that part again, please?
From where?
So once we click on that shape, we will drag and put that profit status to shape. Again, we'll click on that shape after that.
Yeah. So you'll get this dialog box where you'll get two options, true and false. So for false, you can pick up some filled option from there. There are so many options. You might have very limited. I know that. So you select the option, filled option. Then click on false and click on this down arrow. Then select true and click on up arrow. And then apply OK. I hope you're getting two shapes, everyone.
Yes. Previously, you did write that color one, that red color for the false statement and the other color for the true statement. So don't we get that?
Yes. Definitely, we'll get that. But for time being, I understand you're getting this boring shapes. Both are blue color. And if the person is not able to understand between these two, will be difficult, right? I know the pain. So what you do is one extra step. Please drag profit status into color. Everyone, please do one more step. Drag profit status into color. Okay, now have a look on my screen for next few minutes. Have a look on my screen. So please have a look. I went to Google and I'm searching for something named as smiley. I went to Google, search for smiley. And in images, this is one image which I want to tell them, if it is profit, then give me this image. If the profit is less than zero, I want to give this image. Okay, so please observe. I can right click and save the image. I can right click and save the image. It should be in a PNG format. It should be in a PNG format. Somehow I got the image, smiley image, that's a PNG, and I can just click on save button. I saved on the desktop. And second one, sorry, 1 minute. And second one, I can write as negative PNG. Some random images I'm picking up from Google, yeah, like this one. So I can right click and save this image as a PNG format on the desktop, negative. Nothing difficult I've done. I've just downloaded two images on my desktop. One is a negative image and one is a smiley image. These images I want to apply on the charts which I've created. Okay. So what I can do is copy this. See, everyone, first you observe, don't do it. I'm going to copy this image and I'm going to paste in a relevant folder. The folder is, if you remember, this was my documents, my Tableau repository, and initially we picked up the data from this location, data sources, in the morning today. Data sources, we picked up this data. But now what I can do is I will paste this two folders, two images into this folder, shapes folder. So in the shapes folder, I will create one folder named as Wells Fargo images. In Wells Fargo images, I'm going to paste those two images. Okay, so you see in my Tableau repository shapes, I have just created one extra folder, Wells Fargo images, and two images I have pasted. When I go to Tableau, if I click on this shapes button, first of all, you will not be able to see this Wells Fargo anywhere. You will not be able to see Wells Fargo. So you have to... perfect. You know, I used to close the Tableau and reopen Tableau when I started. I didn't know this button should be reload shapes. So reload shapes, and here at the bottom, carefully observe, I'm getting Wells Fargo images. So what name you can see is actually name of the folder I've created. This is nothing but the files which I've copied from Google, PNG files. So now you can understand these are different folders, and these are so many images kept into that folder. I'll pick up Wells Fargo folder here. For false, this image. For true, this smile image. When I click on apply, at the back end, if you see, the images are applied. I know the color is disturbing. So when I click on OK, because there was something in the color, so I'll remove that option outside. Now I'm getting those images. Perfect. So everyone, please download two images and paste into this folder on your desktop. Download any images from Google and paste into this folder. That's the path. Achha, by the way, from where you have to download? You have to download in the virtual machine browser. Do not download on your main machine browser. In virtual machine where Tableau is installed, from there you have to download and paste into this folder. Once you finish, please notify me.
Hey, where do I save this image? Pavan, what is the path I should save this?
Oh, so sorry. So I'm trying to say the images you can save into this folder. So my documents, my Tableau repository, and inside shapes folder, you have to create your own folder.
Okay, so it's always like within that shapes folder. If you put outside shapes folder, it won't take.
No, no. Outside shapes, it won't take. You can give any name, Wells Fargo or anything. Folder name can be anything, no problem. It should be mostly PNG works. Other file formats with the new version they are supporting, but PNG mostly works.
Can you repeat the path, please, again? Pavan, can you repeat? Yeah, okay, sure.
Yeah, so it is in the My Documents, My Tableau Repository, Shapes folder.
So Shapes, mein we have to create the folder name and paste it, right?
Yes, yes. Create any folder and you can paste the image there. So this will help you to take quick decisions. The ultimate goal is using this method, people will easily understand. Right. Okay, I think you have done, everyone.
Right.
Yes, okay, great. This was a simple example. Now, obviously, if you have data very huge, and if you try to bring more and more data, then you can understand how easy it would become. Suppose if I bring the segment into columns, now you see it's quick, easy to understand, which is having profit below zero. Right. Since I had many shapes, I could bring this options, let's say arrows. So you can also download this images, or you get ready-made images. Ready-made images you get in Google. That also I'll be showing you how to get these images. All right. So please rename this as KPI. KPI stands for Key Performance Indicators. KPI stands for Key Performance Indicators. Right. Now I think you are understanding this one. Tableau helps you to take quick decisions. Tableau helps you to take quick decisions. Okay, okay. Last 15 minutes we have. Last 15 minutes. Okay, please see here everyone. 15 minutes. Tableau Public. I'm going to show you a new software named as Tableau Public. 15 minutes I have. Very important. Tableau Public. Your attention again for next 5 minutes. Tableau Public. Tableau Public is a website which is free of cost for everyone, which is available and you get how much? 10 GB of free space. Yeah, so you get 10 GB of free space for lifetime. Please, everyone, very important. Now, in this place, in the Tableau Public, I went to one website named as public.tableau.com. And you see in the gallery option, every day people keep on posting very, very interesting visuals on the screen. These are all the Tableau. These are all created in Tableau. You see, everything is created in Tableau. Okay, it's simple to create. Definitely they spend 3-4 hours to get this one visual here. Now, why I've came to this website? One is you can have a, you know, get some inspiration from this gallery option. Second is if you want to inspire others, you can click on search button here. Now, today what you have done is you have done so many things on Tableau. You will be saving on Tableau desktop. Do not save on Tableau desktop. Do not save on your laptop. Save it on Tableau public platform so that the entire world can see what you have done, how much you have learned. So Tableau public platform.